Yeah. taking a chance on love. Oh, thank you so much, and thank you for coming out. I'd like to thank for Dave for having this, making this possible for us to just out there. I'm like, hi Dave, but you're not Dave, you're Dave. Who are you anyway? No. Anyway, it's so good to see familiar faces. I see folks I haven't seen in a while. And my journey here, and we call this, the idea of this is kind of like a jazz journey. And you might have thought that I was going to give you the history of jazz, but I'm not a scholar in jazz and I can't do that. I'm not even going to try. I have all these notes here, but I figure if I have these notes here, you can probably get the same notes yourself. I'll do a better job than I'll do. So I'll just give you my own personal jazz journey. I think that's going to work out the best. Anyway, it's 10 years since I've been here, almost exactly to the day. I came here in July, Ed and I came here July 4th, 2014, and now here we are. Wow, that was fast. Well, you look great. You haven't changed a bit. And you know, if we're still healthy and we still find reasons to find joy and love in our lives, that's it, right? Isn't that what it's about? Every day, a little bit of joy, a little bit of something, something. It might just be a Snickers bar, but that's okay. It doesn't matter, okay? Anyway, I just want to say thank you for being here. I'm going to be doing a few things. I want to tell you a little bit about the CD, which is like the latest iteration of my journey in jazz. And also, I just want to hang out and sing some songs, and I don't know, maybe even get you involved. You never know with me, right? Anyway, this next tune, first of all, I'm sorry, I'm skipping ahead. I do want to introduce these wonderful gentlemen up here. Aren't they handsome? I'm going to look at them from here. Yeah, ooh. All right, don't start blushing now. Don't even die. So, over there on the bass,
yes,
el guapo ahí on the bass. This is Mauricio Rodrigues. Yeah, and as you all hear, this man does not play, well, he does play on the bass, but he don't play around, he just plays. And then over there, yes, the renegade. Don't even try it, Robin. This is Robin Swenson. So we're doing this a little bit by the fly of our seat of our pants, but you know, pants are good, so are seats. Anyway, we're gonna do a tune that I wrote basically during COVID. You know, I have written a lot of songs, but since I don't play piano, I have to get help. It's a bad handicap, you know. So I'm just my lesson for all of you. If you have something that you can do it well, and you need that other person to help you out or that other situation to help you out, then go get it, pay for it, whatever you're gonna do. So I paid for this, and I got a woman out in LA, Jane Getz, who used to be the sub for Chick Corea, just saying. So she got this song written out for me, you know, into music, and she did a little bit of arranging and refining of my wonderful ideas. And this song is for my two children who are grown up. My daughter's gonna turn 30 in a few days. Wow. Yeah. No, wrong, she's gonna turn 36. My son's gonna turn 30. Okay, let me get it right. So anyway, I'm just gonna share this with you. It's called Child of the Time. Now, it's child, but we know it's like the plural child of the time. Celebrate the love in you.
more blessings to receive. The love that I once gave you is coming back and blessing me. Just for a while, I'll call you mine. But you're a child of the time. Questions, and I pray for guidance so that I could answer them. Now the hand of heaven guides you, and I hope that you can see people struggling, people trying to make love reality.
All together, but since I came here, I've been jumping. You know, you see somebody, and we read about somebody who's been jumping off of cliffs, like, whew, that would be me. That's, it's just been like that one after the other. Just even singing anywhere. I mean, how many of you saw me with Billy and Don, or maybe just me and Billy? Billy Marcus? Anybody remember Billy Marcus? Okay, so we're still here, and Billy's still here. Believe it or not, he's still here. I just talked to him yesterday. He's okay. He's Billy. And I haven't seen Billy in person in 5 years. So I was like, I miss him. I miss his playing. He's amazing. But he shared some very important things with me, which I will always carry forward. Anyway, so I just wanted to tell you that a year ago, or maybe even more like about 2 years ago now, a year and a half, I decided, I had made a CD with Billy and Don and Steve Buckles, and it was wonderful. But, you know, we just did it. We just went in somebody's living room practically and just did it. This time I wanted to make something a little bit more professional, if you know what I mean. And so, but I had no idea how I'd do it. I was like, I had no money. I said, how am I going to do this thing? And I just said, well, I'm going to picture it. I'm holding a CD in my hand. I'm holding a CD. One day I'm going to have the CD. I can see it. I can feel it. I can hear it. I got it. I got the doggone CD. It's like a miracle. It was really, I don't even know how to. All I can say is that, and I think I put this something about this on social media, that sometimes if you really believe in something so much that you just feel it, see it, breathe it, whatever, hear it on the phone, whatever it might be, it can actually happen. It's almost like when you start to do that, you start to act differently, you start to be more alert about what the opportunities and things that can happen that will help you achieve your goal. You're just more aware of them, and so you walk through open doors more easily, and I think that's kind of what happened. Anyway, I can't sell the CD here today. However, in your programs, there's a little insert. And if you want to go and check it out or whatever, some of the tunes I did, like The Child of the Times, is on the CD, but it has a whole lot more instrumentation. And I had wonderful people, even Houston person, actually. This is the deal. So Houston said to Ed, he said, yeah, you tell Zanaya, if she wants me to play on her CD, I'll do it. I'm like, oh, are you kidding me? So yeah, so he did a couple of tunes on the CD, and Catherine Russell, she was coaching me on the CD, so it was really and probably the most amazing thing I've done musically ever. So anyway, just want to let you know about that. This next tune, though, is about the CD. You see, about a year ago, well, maybe more than that, I was looking at women in jazz and just how, as is usual, the custom, women are behind the writers, they're behind the musicians, they're sometimes writing the songs, but they give the credit to their partner or whatever. In jazz is no different. They have not been talked about that much. And there's a lot of history that has gone unnoticed and uncredited for. So I was thinking about women and our place in this world and the trajectory of our lives and how we grow. And being that I am a woman and getting older, and older, hopefully gracefully, you know, that's the whole idea. We're all going to get old, you know, but there's nothing wrong with getting old. You just got to say how you get old, right? So when I came up with this CD, and it's called Water Is My Song, the whole idea is that women in particular, but men as well, we go through this life. And this life is going to be as if it were the sea. It's as if we're swimming in a gigantic sea. And it is tossing us about. Sometimes it's gentle, and sometimes it's rough. But always, it's making an impact. And as we go through the many years and many experiences of being alive and just loving, living in despair, living in hope, living in anger, whatever it might be, all of those things are part of our experience. So it's almost as if we're a stone that is being worn down like a jawbreaker. You know how you kind of wear it down until you get to the essence. And I believe that at the essence of all beings is this amazing core. And you know what that core is? Love. It's simply love. And we grow through these lives, and our parents teach us to do these things, and they tell us what we're supposed to do, and society says, you do this, and they do that, and you make all these crazy lines and boxes and stuff. That's not who we actually are. So for me, it's about remembering who we've always been. Wade in the Water is the next tune. With ease and grace, the water carries me in its sweetness and power. Like a vessel on a boundless sea, I am whole, I am complete, I am free. I am goddess reborn, oh sweet, sweet.
Children, now
So let's do a little something different. You ready?
Yeah, you
can have that. Some people want, you know, it's so demanding. Okay, fine. Oh! to change the group a whole lot. So, it's, you know, the water theme, is running through this. I can, you know, sort of feel it. So this next tune is not on my CD, but I love this song. It's a song that was written by Tashi Reagan, who was the daughter of Bernice Reagan, who has just recently left us or transitioned. She hasn't really left us, but she has transitioned to another kind of a form for us. And she leaves behind an incredible body of work and activism for the well-being and goodness of everybody. Because that's what it's all about. Anyway, Liz Wright. Did anybody see Liz Wright when she was here? She was here at the festival? Well, she was here a couple of years ago, and I got to meet her, and I was like, yes! Oh, quick tale. So, like I said, I got to meet Liz Wright. She's one of my heroes in music. I love her. She has an amazing voice. She has a voice that is ridiculous. It's just so soulful, so deep, so soul-touching. Anyway, what I did with this CD is I did a radio campaign because I wanted to do it the right way. So I got a publicist, I got a radio campaign going, and I actually made it to the top 50 on Jazz Week! I haven't made any money, but that's beside the point. I have something to aspire to. So anyway, I think it was last week, I was you have to be in the top 50, which is like from 50 all the way up to 1. I am not up there. But I did make it to 41. So when I was down at, I was like, I mean, me? Who am I? Well, I am, you know. Anyway, I was just shocked and surprised and happy. So, but at one point, I was right next to Liz Wright. Yeah. It was like Liz Wright, Synia Carroll. I said, anyway, it's really kind of cool. Oh, wow. I bet you thought somebody was sitting in the seat.
I was just hoping it wasn't a bomb.
No, it's actually shoes. I can swear to that. It's the shoes I was thinking about putting on and forgot about. And I forgot that I forgot until just. Anyway, it was just one of those days. Hey, we had a storm. What the heck? So anyway, this song is called When I Fall, and I just like this song. I wanna be wild and bold enough to run with you, my baby. I wanna skip time. Lay the hours aside, stay with you, my baby. But oh, if I look down now, will I fall? Life for oh.
Foley. Let's do Old Devil Moon. Now this is a song you can't sit back on. You gotta get into a jazz groove, you know what I mean, right? So if you can snap, then snap. If you can tap, then tap. I look at you and suddenly something in your eyes I see soon begins bewitching me. It's that old devil moon that just stole from the sky. It's that old devil moon in your eyes. You and your glance make this romance too hot to handle. Stars in the sky blazing so bright can't hold a candle to your little dandle. You got me flying high and wide on a magic carpet ride full of the butterflies inside. Too hot to handle.
your eyes. Move deeper into your eyes. Look deep in your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep in your, sing along with me, bitch. In your eyes, deep in your eyes. What? In your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep in your eyes. Where is it? In your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep in your eyes, deep. I see it in your eyes. Yeah.
It's about, I'm just going to read you a little tiny bit of the poem. Find it. Okay. So she died in 1936. Her name was Alfonsina Storni. She's an Argentinian woman. And she was a poet and very much into forwarding the feminine presence in literacy there. You know how it is for us women, we're always trying to get there. You know, I don't know why this is such a difficult thing, but apparently it is. Anyway, she has this one little, this is a tune I learned because I was a Spanish major in college, and a friend of mine, she used to sing this all the time, and I have loved it ever since 1970 something. And, and I still do. I'm so honored that I got to do this on the CD. But one little verse here I just want to share with you. Because Alfonsina Storni, she did a couple of things besides write. She was also a single parent. So in the 1930s, to have a baby out of wedlock was kind of big. And she kept her kid. And she never let anyone know who the father was. Nobody that I can find. She never told who the father was. So there's a story there. But she'd had cancer and gotten through it, and then it came back. And this time she decided it was time to choose her destiny. And so she chose to let the ocean take her. Now, we call it, you know, dying by suicide, but some folks will look at it a little differently. They'll see that she let herself be transformed by the ocean, be embraced by the water. And so this whole song is about her and her life and the end of her life. This one little line says, "Lower the light a bit more. Let me sleep, nursemaid, in peace. And if he should call, don't ever tell him I am here. Tell him I have gone."
Alfonsina, con tu soledad.
ti, igual el viento y de sal. Te requiebra el alma, la está llevando y te vas hacia allá como en sueños, dormida alfonsina, vestida de
I do know we started late, so that's why it seems like that. Okay, let's do. How deep is you?
Yeah. Shirley Horn.
Oh, you want to do the Shirley Horn one? That's another slow one. Okay, wait. Okay, we should do. We probably should get ready to wind it down one more tune. So we have a choice. We can do something that's medium tempo. Or we could do another ballad by Shirley Horn, which is one of my favorite tunes in the whole world, Here's to Life, which I'd be honored to do. So how do you feel about that? Let's take a straw poll. How many of you want to do the it's going to be slow, but it's a beautiful tune. So who wants to hear the slow tune? Raise your hand. Okay. Who wants to hear a medium tune? Medium tune? Raise your hand. Oh, this is fun. You want to be upbeat? Oh. Okay, so I'll tell you what. We'll do the upbeat one, and then for those who can hang, we'll do the slow one. Okay, let's do it. We're going to do a tune with a whole different beat. Okay, so Willie's all about this. Okay, I lost a dear friend this year. And she didn't have much family here, so I spent a lot of time with her in her last days. And it was really kind of weird because I sang this song, you know, I was singing songs to her and stuff like that. You don't know what to do, right? You do the best you can. And I sang this song to her, and I said, ooh, is this the right song? But it's about learning how to fly. And that could be flying in this life. It could be flying in our next transition life. It's all about finding our wings, our the thing that makes us float, that makes us go, and makes us live with passion. So that's what it's all about. So learning how to fly. Thank you.
Thank you.
the memories you've memorized to keep your winters warm. For there is no yes in yesterday, and who knows what tomorrow brings or takes away. As long as I'm still in the game, I want to play for life, for laughs, for love. So here's to life and every joy it brings. Here's to life, dreamers and their dreams.
Your heart and a sparkle to your eye. Thank you all so much.